Be very, very quiet. I'm hunting wabbit. Good morning, folks, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die with your host, Rongo. Yay! Finally hit stone. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Okay, finally hit stone. It has been... It's a long way down here. That's good. Alright, we're going to get back out now that we're down. Where's that? Okay, start heading up. So I didn't get as much accomplished last night as I wanted to. I was... We had a couple wandering hordes that came by and just... wouldn't disappear, so I couldn't get a whole lot of actual work accomplished. But we did manage to go down another 23 blocks down, so we're down about 30 blocks down before we actually found rock. So it is way down there. I went ahead last night on the way home. I found a lovely purse with some antibiotics in it. So I went ahead and took those, try and get our wellness to start coming back up a little bit. So our wellness right now is at 41, which is, you know, not too bad. Didn't die again, so that is also good. Went ahead and did a little more maintenance in here. This is our other antibiotic we've got, so that's good. I went ahead and turned that one corn on the cob into corn seeds. We have that and don't have the urge to eat it. So we've got crops to plant. We just need to be able to plant. We've got a little bit of food here, so I'm going to go ahead and grab a can of pasta, and we've got some water. I'm going to go ahead and grab my yucca juice. Keep my golden rod for later on. It's not a replenishable resource. I got some more yucca. Let me put these in here as well, just to keep them set. Now, the plan for today... Oops. Actually, let me put these in here. I'm going to bring these with in case we can find another toilet. And we will fill those up. So the plan for today is to just finish looting the town. I keep getting distracted by shiny things. I'm like a frickin' squirrel, I swear. Alright, I did make some more bolts as well. Collected a bunch more rocks off screen on the way home last night. Picked up a bunch of just kind of a little bit of everything while I was running around. So that was good. So here's that yucca juice. Yummy. Want to hear what that horde did last night, because I heard all kinds of pounding and I heard stuff falling. So I'm gonna take a look here and just see what did they do on the way through. Okay, they definitely hit the side of this house up a bit more. So they did a little bit of damage, not too much. Have I checked this car? Yes, I have checked that car. Yeah, these guys are all checked. Okay, all right. So we've hit that building that we know for Soyton, and we hit the building behind it as well. So everything else on the block, I think we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 buildings to check. At church, is that a church? No, that's a church. So all right, let's go ahead. Is there a door? It's pretty hosed. Those fronts are really easy to go through, though, so let's... Yeah, I think the front is easier than that door is. Or... Alright, I have an announcement to make. I am going to do a viewer, subscriber play session. So on New Year's weekend, so basically January 3rd, which is a Saturday, I'm going to do host it on my server. I'm going to go ahead and put... Oh, yes, I'll take that. Pistol barrel. We've got a lot of pistol barrels now. So anyway, I'm going to host on my server. It's a 10-slot server. I'm going to reserve 2 slots for myself and possibly Diandra D, who is someone I'm going to be doing a co-op gameplay session with. starting the weekend after Christmas, or coming up here shortly. So we're going to start a little co-op gameplay session. And then, so if she's on, then we'll go ahead and play. She'll be on there as well, but otherwise it'll just be me and you guys. Another potato seed. Awesome! Oh, jeez. How about a freaking forge book? Asshat. So, the basic gist is I'm going to do two sessions. I'm gonna stream them live on Twitch. So the first session will be in the morning on that Saturday, and it will be probably like 9 a.m. Mountain Time until noon Mountain Time, and then a second session from about 2 p.m. Mountain Time until I feel like stopping. So the server is password protected, so I will be using the same password that I use for the contest. Oh, and speaking of the contest, I forgot. I finally was able to nail down the winner of the contest for my first 100 subscribers. And we've been going back and forth. I think he's a young kid and was having a little bit of trouble getting going. But anyway, he picked Far Sky, and he goes by The Last Joker. He did change his gamer tag kind of midstream, but anyway, Last Joker, he was my pick, random pick for the 100 subscriber contest. He answered Goldenrod correctly, and Goldenrod will be the password for the server as well, and I'll have that posted in the link. So there'll be 8 slots open. It's gonna be first come, first serve. If you want to play, you're more than welcome. I do have a question for the community: is how difficult should we make it? Should we make it insane, or should we make it kind of livable? Right now, it's set up with a kind of fun seed. I kind of played around a little bit, made sure it all looks good, and it does. I think it's like "Welcome, Rongo fans" is the seed of the game, and right now I've got it set for kind of medium settings with medium loot and everything else. So. Anyway, I hope you guys are excited about that. Just a chance. I know a lot of people were interested in playing, so I thought this would be really fun. And I'm also going to stream it on Twitch live during those times as well. So if you don't want to play but you want to watch, you're more than welcome to follow on Twitch. So I will be posting all those details in the descriptions for the videos, and I'll put some annotations on as well during that time so that you guys are able to find that stuff really easy. So I think I pretty much talked most of the way through this stupid freaking door. These things got really tough. All right. So anyway, yeah, that's exciting. I'm really excited about that and looking forward to that. So let me go ahead and I'm gonna pound through these other doors, and that means I don't have to sit through all that stuff. What do we got in here? Oh, more eggs. I'll take them. And all right. These are weird. These doors are just. It's like, look at that door. It's like a double weird problem. So, wow, my roommates are being extremely noisy right now. Oh well, don't mind. Now I learned my lesson. Downstairs has got an easier door to go through. So let's do that. Let's not be. Not be silly. Alright, so I'll go ahead and cut to this again. Okay, we broke into these doors. And what we got in here? Oh, it's like everything in the world is locked up tight. One more cut. We've got a wandering horde. Out. Is it a wandering horde, or is it just one or two of them? Okay, it looks like just one or two. I thought for a second that I had a wandering horde on us, and I was going to be a little worried. Freaking hornet is flying around out here too. My nemesis. I do like the fact that they've added the wandering hordes back in. It was getting a little. Now the question is, will spiders summon? Why can I not hit this guy? Thank you. And Nursey. Where is she going? Do you know something I don't know? Yes, the question is, will those the spiders that are just wandering like that, are they scouts? Or are they just regular zombies? So they won't... stupid tree. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Hello. Hey, nude walker. Oh, nice. Crit. Now, nails, I just haven't been picking up very much because you need... I think you need 3 nails to make into 1 scrap iron. So they've been fairly expensive. You gotta pick up a lot of them to make it make sense picking them up. So, okay, we got a bookcase in here. Come on, please. We have like every book. We have like SMG schematics and all the guns, MacGyvers, everything else. All we freaking need is a forge book. Oh my god, what is up with this? This has been absolutely ridiculous. Oh god, here it is. Oh yes. Okay, I'm just going for it right now. Running right for it. I can't miss this one. It seems to be the regular route. They seem to be going north to south, or south to north on each one, so that's good to know. I mean, maybe... Yeah, that's good. I like that. Alright, let's eat. Go ahead and eat one of these blueberry pies. Blueberry pies are nice because they give you a lot of fullness and stamina, and the only problem is they're really expensive to make as far as ingredients. They require egg and... hello, rabbit, you're gonna die. Hello, rabbit, you're so tasty. Please come in my belly again. Oh, come on, rabbit. The twigs, you see that stick, the stick bushes? They, oh, quiet. All right, let's... Okay, now he's staying still. But I can't hit him there. Okay, there we go. There we go, perfect! Alright. I hope we don't lose that supply crate because of a stupid rabbit. Alright, so it should be right here. Well, I see another rabbit. Hello, rabbit. Be very, very quiet. I'm hunting wabbit. Come on, rabbit. Sorry, I went out there. I'm trying to track this stupid rabbit. Alright. Supply crate? Oh, there you are. There you are. Very good. Come on, did I check this already? Oh, I had not checked this already. Empty. I'll take the iron reinforced just in case. SMG, iron chest, sniper handguard, antibiotics, first aid. You know, I think I have all the parts of the freaking sniper rifle. Those supply crates have been freaking awesome lately. But it's sad. I mean, like I said, it's really freaking sad that I've got all that stuff. Let me just look for sniper... sniper rifle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't have a scope, I don't think. I have everything but the scope. Okay. Let's take a look here. We are out. It's fairly early in the day. I'm being distracted again. I'm not getting my looting done in the town, which might be a problem. Okay, let's just head back to the house. If we spot that other... either a rabbit or another supply drop will find it, but I'm trying to look at the map because I'm trying to remember where the other one came down. I thought it was right along this path. Then maybe let's head kind of around that way back to the base, just in case it is like right over there and I've just missed it. And I'm gonna keep hitting these. I want to build a nice stockpile of both eggs, because at this point we might end up eating eggs. There's no bacon in this area, unfortunately. Alright, grab that. Let's head up here on this. I know I've been on this ridge before. I was up here last night gathering cactus. In fact, let's go ahead and do a few more cactus while I'm at it. These things are pretty good. I mean, you could live on these. So far my impression of the desert is they've definitely tweaked it. You can survive in the desert, but you cannot thrive in the desert. There's enough, you know, food and material to keep you alive, but it's really tough to do more than just, you know, the basics out here. The lack of trees is a big problem, as is the lack of goldenrod, animals other than rabbit. I mean, there's tons of rabbit, but that's all you get is rabbit. All right, so let's... Oh, look, right there! Holy shit, right there. Okay, I don't want to break a leg, so let's kind of go down a little bit at an angle-y. There we go, perfect. All right. That's awesome. See? My instincts were perfectly right on track. All right, I'm going to go ahead and bust up. Bear with me, guys. Grab a few rocks and more iron here. So far, the only iron I've gotten, because I've dug 30 down and just hit stone. So hopefully tonight I'll be able to dig a little farther down and let me drink some yucca juice. See, yucca juice is pretty good. It's not as good as goldenrod, but you also get a wellness perk, which either that was coincidental or you actually do get it. So I'll have to keep an eye on that. If yucca juice can give you a wellness boost, I'll be drinking a lot more yucca juice. All right, let's grab a couple of these boulders. Yeah, starting with tonight, I should have no problem building that up. And what I could do, I was thinking I could rim the house with rock, with stone, but that's gonna require a lot of stone, and the zombies still tunnel right through stone. If you don't believe me, you can check out the multiplayer service, Bearded Bob's multiplayer stream, and you can watch on our last base how the zombies just ripped right in. Okay, how about a sniper scope? Boots and chest stock. Okay, I'll leave that. Let's read these guys. Read that. We don't need that, definitely. I think we already have a SMG stock. I'm not positive. Alright, well, we can pick it up in a second here. Let's go ahead and read these things. So when you bust those chests open, it does... Let's go over here and drop it. Two of those. That's ridiculous. Alright, let's pick up that stuff. Let's get rid of the nails. Get rid of the sandwich. Okay. Alright, let's get back out of here. We had an awesome loot run there. Two supply chests. There are crates. Very nice. Very nice. Yep, we hit that one. Okay. Let's check this building out. Yes, please. Okay. Already got that. This is unlocked. Oh, screw you. Screw you. And this is one of those tough ones, too, I think. Are there any windows? Any good windows? Whoa, what the hell? It was like weird. It was like the rattlesnake sound, and then I hit that. And I'm like, what the hell? Rattlesnakes? They aren't real. I mean, they're real, but they're not really here. All right, let's do it the smart way. It's far easier to go through a window. Whoops. It's far easier to go through the windows than it is to go through anything else, so. We'll do that. Boop. See, we can bypass our stupid doors. Who needs doors anyway? Alright. What? Okay, wait, how? Oh. Oh, wow. I'm like a genius or something. A genius is stupid. Jeez. So we don't need to worry about that. We've already looted that all up. Oh, we haven't. We must have just walked in here or something. All right. We are full. Let's run back to the house really quick. We'll dump this stuff off. And then come back out, and we'll finish looting these houses up. We've got two more days before zombie... And I think that for day 7, the basic thing is we're going to hide down in a hole. Alright, rabbits. We got 20 rabbits. That's nice. Okay, we got to start cooking those guys up here pretty soon. Antibiotics, we'll stack in there. More pain pills. Yes, please. More aloe, more yucca, oops, there we go, let's see, what else can we stack away here, that, eggs, got a lot of, okay, we are getting a little bit of food, which is nice, okay, this is a good thing, let's keep this pie, well, let's eat the pie, we can use the eats, okay, sniper rifle, so, barrel, sniper, yes, the only thing we're missing is the scope. Wow. That's kind of sadly amazing. And we've got more of that. We've even got some bullets for the sniper rifle, or the hunting rifle, actually. So that's pretty good to know. We've got plenty of shell casings. So if we can find some lead, we got a little bit of lead, we could actually make, yeah, we could make bullets, except we don't have any coal. No coal yet. Alright, well, lots of things we need to kind of tweak. Yeah, we need to tweak things a bit more. Barrel. Alright, pipe. Sorry, I don't mean to belabor the point here and do too much management, but I want... Yeah, we've got a lot of... Okay, we are getting a lot of planks. So we can build stuff, we just can't make any... So tomorrow, we are going to put out... We have two parts of the freaking SMG gun. Damn. Tomorrow we're going to put out some spikes. I think that's a good thing to do. Let's get that. That doesn't give you any fullness or any hydration. It's a little sad. Okay. Have we checked... Yes, check that. We've checked that one. We've checked that one. We've checked this one. So all we have left is picking up more things off the ground. I know, you guys are like, please stop picking. I know we left some things behind because we were full, so let's just check them. Okay. Perfect. Perfect. Would you guys be interested in me doing kind of a how-to session, some how-to series? I did. That was the door down. Let's check up here on top. I opened that up, but I didn't actually check it. Anyway, kind of more of an actual tutorial series where I, you know, do focus on one kind of thing, like build, how to build the scrap metal thing, or how to build, stuff like that. No, I can't even describe it. Let me know in the comments if you would be interested. I can just make them short, you know, kind of like 5-minute videos of how to do this, how to do that. It's kind of probably been overdone, but I just thought it would be fun to... Home maintenance, yes. Okay, can. This is where we were in when the plane ran overhead. Remember that. Wow. Just wow. So, we are without a forge book. We first searched this entire town. No forge book. Everything but the forge book. I mean, almost literally everything but the forge book. That is really sad. So, that means we're going to have to run... Oh, man. Day 5. No forge. Suggestions? Suggestions? Anyone? Anyone? I didn't miss anything. Now I'll take the lead just because. Wow. Let's go in here. I'm just going to go in the house real fast. Close up a little bit. Alright, let's take... I want to show you guys this. Let's make some spikes. Let's make some spiked wood spikes. Here we go. So these are really cheap to make. Basically, 3 planks of wood is what it costs. One of the interesting things about them, each one burns for 36 seconds, and a stick burns for 4 seconds. So you get so you get 3 log spikes, 1, 2, 3, you get 3 spikes out of it. So a stick burns for 4 seconds. This burns so that would be a total of 12 seconds. This burns for 36 seconds. You get 3 times the burn length out of a wood spike. So if you're hungry for cooking material, you can turn your wood into logs to 6 spikes, and you can actually get a little bit more duration, I guess, out of your stuff. So just keep that in mind. I'm going to knock this post out of the way. This way we can put a little bit of defense up. Well, it's not going to be much. Zombies tend to walk right through these things, so I don't expect them to hold to, you know, to make it much of a difference. But, you know, at this point, because this is pretty much all we can do, we might as well do something. We'll collect that stick. There we go. Let's just place it. Oh, what the hell? Wow. So basically, my wellness is so low that mislaying a spike can kill me. Yeah, that's impressive. That is really impressive in a wow, you're a moron kind of way. Well, it's back down to 40. I was up to 50. Things were getting better. Life was slightly less sucky. And then it became re-sucky, I guess. I guess that's a word. Re-suckied. Oh. I feel like this playthrough, I'm just not getting ahead. Not getting ahead. Oh, well. Things will change. My luck will turn, and we will once again be kings of the world. But this is definitely not the epic playthrough that season 3 was, or season 2 was, or season 1. Season 1 was pretty epic. I was pretty much owning on that one. So be careful when you're putting these spikes down. They evidently cause enough damage to kill you fairly easily and quickly in a really pathetic, sad manner. Alright, I'm going to go in here. I did check all this stuff, right? Yeah. Alright, I'm just going to use the toilet. I'm going to fill this up again. There we go. What's that zombie all whining about out there? Is he in the house? I'm also going to pick up these sofas for burn. Like I said, normally I don't burn sofas, but in this case, everything is so short supply that I'll take anything to burn at this point. Upstairs? Yeah, where'd you? You must have spawned in here later on. Wow, oh. Yeah. I'll grab it. I mean, it saves me 2 planks, I guess, right? Every little bit helps. Oh. Alright folks, well that's it for this episode. If you liked my ineptitude, go ahead and click that like button. Leave a comment, subscribe, tell your friends, your family, and your grandmother. And I will see you guys tomorrow.